is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to you on a quick video. I wanted to let you guys know I got some new merchandise available, not just t-shirt anymore. I got different type of t-shirt, different type of shirts and logos that you can purchase on my spread shirt, and also hoodies now. We have expanded and added more to the channel and more merchandise for the brand. Thanks for supporting. It will be in the description and the links will be in the comment section below. Thanks for helping me and supporting the movement. Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis. I'm going to check out the video. What's good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to y'all with a quick video. We're going to talk about Rodney McGruder and Jamychal Green going to the Los Angeles Clippers. Jamychal Green is only getting a two-year deal, and I feel like it's a great pickup for the Clippers to get a guy like Jamychal Green to stay. He obviously played last year with the Clippers. He was an acquisition that they have made, and he fits what they're trying to do. He's 29 years old. He's a 6'9", 227 power forward. Also can play the three. This is a guy that really played 24 games for them last season, gave them 48% from the field and 41% from three last year in the 24 games that he played. Also gave you 8.6 rebounds in that time. He also played for Memphis 41 games for Memphis and still gave you the 48 and 39% from the three-point line. He's a hot commodity. That's why he got paid the money that he got paid, to be able to be that stretch four and that guy that can be a small ball five, depending on what lineup and what team the opposing team has on the court. This guy is very valuable in those 15 to 25 minutes, can make a real difference, especially when you have guys like Paul George and Kawhi Leonard and Lou Williams handling the ball, getting him easy opportunities and easy looks, and just feeding him the ball with dunks or spot-up jumpers or even spot-up threes. I think he's going to have a blast this year playing with upgraded talent. And I think that that's just going to make his job so much more easier. And all he has to do, really focus on it, is knocking down the open shots that he's going to be given. And he doesn't have to really do too much other than that. And with his role being a little decreased, because they do have Kawhi Leonard and Paul George, you don't really have to expect too much out of him. They could pan him like a quality role player, and he has shown even last year that that's what he is and that's what he can be. I like Rodney McGruder. Also played 3 years with the Miami Heat, shows potential to be a guy that can play the one or the two in the three and guard those positions, and sometimes the four, depending on who's the four out there on the opposing team. He's a legitimate 6'4", can knock down threes, and he also showed his ability to be more than just a three-point shooter. He's not the most efficient player, but in those minutes that he gets, he knows where to be at on the court, what the team needs him to do, and they're paying him like they have a lot of interest and see a lot of potential in him. And like I said before, Doc Rivers is one of those coaches where he gets the best out of his players. He knows where to put them, he knows how to utilize them, and he knows the exact lineups to get them put them in and get the best out of them. And Doc Rivers even showed that last year, winning 48 games with no superstar on his roster, even when they had Tobias Harris. Tobias Harris was playing like an all-star caliber player, but he wasn't playing as a superstar caliber player. Then I can see why they chose to get McGruder and Jamychal Green to come to this roster and stay, because these are the type of guys that you want, guys that can defend, guard, and play multiple positions, and also knock down shots when they don't have the ball and play off the ball. And if you're going to run a lot of sets for Paul George and Kawhi Leonard, you're going to want to have space. And even if they do go down, you want to have multiple players that you can trust and rely on to come in there and give you those quality minutes when you have an injury or you need to give them 10 to 15 minutes or get in foul trouble. You want to have those pieces where you can try different things also, and it'll give you more variety. That gives you more versatility, having more weapons and more opportunities to throw different lineups out there that can really either give your team an advantage or give your team the lineup that you need to counter the other team, which gives you an advantage defensively and offensively. So I think that they put this roster together very smart. They got a lot of interchangeable pieces, a lot of players that can guard and defend multiple positions, and they got a lot more floor spacing than they had last year. There was already a great three-point shooting team. Now they got even better, in my personal opinion, this year. Obviously, getting Paul George and Kawhi Leonard, but also getting guys like Jamychal Green to come back, and McGruder showed that he's a capable three-point shooter also. So I think the Clippers have really filled this roster out very well. This team is very complimentary with the talent that they have with their stars. And at the same time, they have the defense, they have the shooting, and now they have the two superstars to take them to that level of being a championship. That's why they are the favorites right now. Who would have thought that the Los Angeles Clippers would be the favorites to win the NBA championship, especially after they didn't draft Paul George or Kawhi Leonard? They was able to get one of the biggest free agents, if not the best free agent, after Kevin Durant went down with the injury available. They were able to get the best free agent available in Kawhi Leonard. Then they was also able to get one of the best players and MVP candidates this year in Paul George. And now they have a bunch of role players that is interchangeable and fits exactly what they're trying to do scheme-wise and defensively and offensively. So this team is loaded. I love their role players. I love their defensive wings and their perimeter players. And now I just want to see them get a rim protector. They can get a nice rim protector to, clog up that paint and four shots away. Or maybe they can let Montrezl Harrell, he's more switchable, he's not the best defender, but he can guard more positions. He does have mobility and lateral quickness. Or you can try to see what Zubac can become. But I think that that's the main thing they're missing. They got the shooting, they got the defense, they got the superstars, they got the ball handlers, they have the everything they need besides the rim protector. The guy that can get shots out of there, rebound, and protect the ball, set screens, to get guys open shots and easy shots. And, you got Doc Rivers, you just need that guy that can really lock down that paint to go with the perimeter defense of Kawhi Leonard, Paul George, and Patrick Beverley. So I'm loving it. This is one of the most exciting seasons for the Clippers in NBA history. Nobody really seen them pulling this off years ago. If you would have told me that Kawhi Leonard and Paul George would choose to go to the Clippers years ago, I would have called you crazy, especially after they traded Chris Paul and Blake Griffin. And now already 2 years later, they back in probably better than they ever have been. It's probably the best Clipper team that they have ever put together. And the crazy part about it is free agency not even over. The season hasn't even started, and the trade deadline and the buyouts haven't even passed yet. And we already seeing this team get strategically put together. And I have to give them full credit. They are doing a fantastic job. And when I look at this team, I still feel like they can make some more minor tweaks to this roster. Not saying that they need it, but this team can get even better possibly in the future, even if it is just trading some of their little pieces and trying to get better small-wise. So they don't really need that many changes. They definitely don't need to do or rush or feel like they have to make the moves that's unnecessary. But it is kind of crazy that they do have this type of roster this fast. And Jerry West, like I said, is a guy that build dynasties, and it looks like they might potentially have one in this season with Kawhi Leonard and Paul George. So this is very crazy, kind of surreal. If I'm a Clippers fan, I just can't believe this right now, but this is literally reality at the end of the day for the NBA. This is the best. So let me know what you guys think about the Los Angeles Clippers. Do you think they should be champion contenders? Do you think that they are one of the favorites to win the title? Do you think they are the favorites to win the title? Whatever you feel about this team, let me know in the comment section below. At the end of the day, remember, Rodney McGruder is 27. He is a legitimate 6'4", 200 pounds. He shot 35% from three last year on 3.4 attempts. He shot 42%. The year before that in 1.9 attempts. He is a guy that can give you 15 to 25 minutes. And like I said, can guard multiple positions and also score, give you some playmaking a little bit, and give you some off the ball scoring. So he ain't going to be a big needle mover. He ain't going to be this crazy glue guy, but you already have that already on your roster. So you don't really need him to fill that void. So That's that. But I love the pickups they have made. I love how this team shaped up. And I really can't believe that this is reality. But it's crazy. Let me know what you guys think. Is Rodney McGruder a sneaky pickup? How do you guys personally feel about them re-signing Jamychal Green? He was a great player for them last year. Played some of the best basketball of his career with the Los Angeles Clippers. And it looks like that they willing to go all in on him, giving him double-digit money. Stretch fours are still hot, and they still are very viable, especially when they're as athletic and mobile as Jamychal Green. And, you know, now you got that position filled, and now you got a backup stretch four. So you have the versatility right then and there. But I'm loving this team. Let me know what you guys think. Quinn Wade, basketball analysis, I'm gone. And please subscribe and like and comment. And let me know what you guys think about these two pickups. Check out my Facebook page, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Check out my website, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Thanks for everybody that likes on Facebook. Thanks for everybody that likes the videos. Thanks for everybody that comments. I like the activity that you guys have shown. I answer comments that make sense, if that makes sense. And also, at the end of the day, if you like this video, check out my older videos on my channel. I have many playlists. I break down rookies. I break down players. I break down summer league. I do cover the draft, and I got a mock draft up already. Not only that, I do podcasts, and I also talk about the game of basketball, whether it comes to summer league, free agency, trade deadline, buyouts, and also I cover top 10 discussions and stuff like that. So you like this type of video, you like the NBA, check out my older videos and my playlists. I enjoy making these videos. You guys enjoy watching. I'm going.